I didn't grow up loving the theater. I was more of a movie kind of gal. I liked the polished nature of it, and theater, quite frankly, made me uncomfortable because it was a little too real. It was a little too imperfect. And having now raised and been in the process of raising up a couple of theater kids and being more and more exposed to theater kids and more exposed to people like Allie, I have come to hold a great and abiding love for the theater. There are no retakes. And in honor of that, I'm going to try to do this in a single take and to be as real and as open as I can. There is something that is utterly holy about the telling of a story, and there is something that is utterly holy about a human being who stands in front of other people and holds their vulnerability out under the stage lights where we can see it. There's something incredible about the giving of oneself to be able to tell a story so that other people can see it, other people can come into the story, other people can identify with the story, and that their lives and their hearts can be transformed by it. And we can see a bit of what others feel. We can learn compassion, we can learn sympathy, we can hopefully even in some instances develop empathy with other people. We can never really step into another person's shoes, but we can get a glimpse into worlds that we might not see where they're not actors who open that door for us, so that we can get a window into a world that we might not necessarily live in. And so it's people like Allie and people like the folks that you're going to see as this video progresses who help us to become better versions of ourselves, because they're willing to set themselves and their insecurities aside so that we can learn. We are a stiff-necked and a hard-hearted people at times. So thanks be to God for the ones who are willing to tell stories so that we can find Christ in those stories, so that we can be molded and shaped by them, because God is so great at telling stories. And it's because of His great and glorious story of redemption that we can even move and breathe and hope and love. So I wanted to read a prayer for you, for Allie's family, for those of us who have deeply loved her and been affected by her life, by the ministry of her work upon the stage. And so I'm going to read a liturgy that's called Before Taking the Stage. And I think it encompasses Allie's gifting so well. So hear these words as if Allie were the one who prayed them. What have I to offer here that might sustain the souls of others? Alone, I have little more to show beneath this scrutiny of lights than my own pride and insecurity, my craving for praise, my fear of rejection. Rather, let me offer something greater in this place, O Christ. As I step onto this stage, meet me amidst the wreckage of my ego and my woundedness, and through me, give what I alone cannot. I offer you all that I have, my talents, my training, the years spent honing and crafting and creating, my passions, my personality, my history, the many sacrifices I and others have made in order for me to be here. I give you even my brokenness, of which I am also a steward. I offer now these complete and insufficient provisions, remembering how you, in your days among us, twice blessed inadequate offerings, fashioning them into miraculous feasts that would sustain crowds in their hard journeys. I pray that you would likewise receive and bless and multiply my own meager gifts, Jesus, for the benefit of all who have gathered here. Let these humble elements in your hands become a true nourishment for those who hunger for you and for those who have not yet wakened to their deepest hungers. Let my brief service to them be like the opening of a window through which the breezes of a far country might blow, stirring eternal longings to life. Take this tiny heap of my talents and my brokenness alike, this jumble of what is best and worst in me, and meld it to the greater work of your Spirit, using each facet as you will, so that even as sunlight coursing through a cracked prism, your grace might somehow be revealed upon this stage in whatever glorified and peculiar patterns you have fashioned me to display. Amen. Thank you, Allie. Your performance was real and raw and beautiful. And may the work that you submitted to the Holy Spirit be transformational in us all.
Hey, Davis family, it's Jack Boyce. Just wanted to give you a quick little message about how deeply saddened I was to hear this news about Allie. And just to say that, you know, all of us feel this way, but me personally, I feel like the world is a worse place without her in it. So, and to think about how fragile all of our lives are, I always think about this song. Sting.
On and on, the rain will fall, like tears from the star, like tears from the star. On and on, the rain will say how fragile we are, how fragile we are.
Our hearts are with you.
Allie just had the sweetest, warmest smile that really embodied the tenderness and the sweetness of who she was. And I'm so grateful that I got to know her and work with her at Jenny Wiley. And I wanted to send love to all of her family and friends and everyone during this shocking and difficult time.
But I know I'm who I am today because I knew.
Hey, Davises, Matthew here, if you don't remember me. Just wanted to send you guys some love and let you know that I'm thinking about you in this time. I don't know what to say, but just know that I love you guys and I loved Allie and still do. And I wanted to remind you of a memory that I have from when we were doing Annie, and we were all so excited that Allie was gonna be going in, and but we hadn't really had any rehearsals or anything, and I just remember being so nervous before, and then as soon as we started, I said, oh, this girl has got it, we're fine. And there were times when she didn't really know where to go on stage. We were sort of pushing her around, but every time I looked down at her in that little red wig and that huge smile, it just, you know, made me so happy and excited. And her smile is in a lot of memories that I have in my time at Jenny Wiley, and those are the best times of my life, and I'm so glad I got to share those with her. So thank you for sharing her with us. It really means a lot, and she is sorely missed and will be remembered in our hearts forever.
Like a seed dropped by a sky bird in a distant world. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I know you.
I am so sorry to hear about Allie. My prayers are with you guys. She is so wonderful, so beautiful, so kind, spunky. If there's anything I can do, please, please let me know. I'm so sorry, and I'm praying for you guys.
And none of it seems to matter anymore.
Smith, and I had the pleasure of knowing Allie for numerous years through dance. She was absolutely an amazing person. She was always so full of life and just cheerful, and everyone always loved being around her. I would like to go and watch her do the Jenny Wiley performances, and she did really good at those. She had a very, very promising future, and there's no doubt in my mind that she wouldn't have been a Broadway star. Allie, you are such an amazing person, and you're going to be missed by so many people in our community. And I just want to say to your parents that I am so sorry for your all's loss. And I hope that you know just how special Allie was to everyone that she ever encountered in her life.
Was one of the kindest, sweetest, silliest, most fun, joyous people I think I've ever known in my whole life. I don't think I ever saw a smile not on her face, other than maybe one time when our choreographer yelled at us during Annie and made one of the little ones cry. Well, Allie knew how to speak up for people without a voice, and she did just that. She let the choreographer know that some people just can't handle the way that she was teaching, and she let the little one know that it was okay, everything was going to be just fine, and that messing up is normal, and everyone does it, and that's something I'll always look up to Allie for. She knew how to talk to people and let them know not only that things were going to be okay, but also when things were wrong. She knew how to gracefully tell someone when they messed up, and I think that's something that not many people have, and I think that was one of the most beautiful things about her, and I truly look up to her for that, and I hope someday that I can be as gracious as she was to people. I know that these few days have been hard, and you all have been in our prayers, and we love you so, so, so much, and I just know that if I can't wait for the day that I get to see her again in heaven, I can't think of how much more so you all are looking forward to that day. So just know that we're thinking of you and praying for you, and we love you so, so, so much.
Courtney Cunningham, and we're coming to you from Orlando, Florida, and we had the privilege of working with Allie at Jenny Wiley Theater.
The first time we ever got to meet Allie was back in 2009, our first time working at Jenny Wiley, and we were doing Broadway Kids as one of the productions that the adults did with the Jenny Wiley kids at the time, and I was really lucky. We were doing the number Seize the Day from Newsies, and I got paired with Allie as my partner in that song, and it was my job to pick her up at the end and put her up onto my shoulder. And I had dropped a person a while back ago, an adult, doing something similar, and so I was really trepidatious about doing it and nervous, and I'll never forget, she looked at me with her little newsy cap on and she said, "It's okay, Mr. Dustin, I trust you." And that's probably the most comforted I ever been by a child as an adult. And I'll never forget it. And, you know, it was a really special experience getting to know her as a kid and to watch her grow.
That's right. And then later, a few years later, about 5 years later, we came back to Jenny Wally to work, and we got to see Allie in a show, and it was just so amazing to watch her grow and develop as a performer. She really lit up the stage, and we have fond memories of her, and I'm sure you do too. So we're thinking about all of Allie's family and friends during this time.
All the best.
Hi there, my name is Lauren Gismondi, and I worked with Allie at the Jenny Wiley Theater from 2011 to 2013. And I just want to share with y'all how special she was to us and how moving her performances were and what a joy she was to work with in rehearsals. She's not somebody I'm going to easily forget. And I wish you all solace in this time. Be well. Take your time.
Hi, everybody. First, I just want to say how heartbroken I am over Allie. And my thoughts and my prayers are going out to you. So they asked us to share some memories that we have of Allie from Jenny Wiley. So I'm about 10 years older than Allie, and I'll never forget the year that she did Broadway Baby in the Broadway Kids. And we were rehearsing at this Catholic church in Prestonsburg. So when the kids would get breaks, of course, you know, they wanted to all go outside and play and just, you know, be rambunctious. And I remember Allie fell, and I had a first aid. I was the first aid kid. I was kind of like the babysitter for the kids. I was backstage helping the kids get mics, get all that stuff when they did that one. So during rehearsals, you know, I was kind of like babysitter. Like, they needed something, I helped them. So Allie had fallen and scraped her knee. And so I was helping her, and I swear, I don't know why, I just always remember, like, just she just looked up at me and she was like, "Thank you, you're the best," and just gave me the biggest hug. That was one of the first memories I have of her that I'll never forget. And honestly, there's just so many, but the main thing about all of the moments that I've had with Allie is that she was just always so happy, so loving, so caring, so beautiful inside as well as out, so talented. She was just a beautiful soul, and it really makes me sad that this tragedy had to happen to such a beautiful, beautiful, talented young lady. And my last little thing I want to say is, you know, as a parent, I just can't even imagine what you are going through, but just know that you will be in my thoughts and prayers, and I hope you know how wonderful of a daughter you raised. And she was just so kind to everyone, always had a smile, and I'm just so sorry. I'm so sorry for your loss. If there's anything, and I do mean anything, that I can do for you, please, please let me know.
Allie Davis. She was a special individual in my life, but not only mine, but definitely everyone at Prestonsburg. There was an article talking about how she was the star of the Star City, and nothing could be more accurate. And I don't just mean a star on the stage and singing and acting and every special thing she did. I mean, she was a star. She lit up everyone's world. Her smile was contagious. Her laugh was contagious. She was someone that you could never feel alone around. She was always there for everyone. I know that I could go years without talking to her, and she would still have my back when I needed her most. Nothing meant more to me than when she helped support the Black Lives Matter movement in Prestonsburg, Kentucky. I've never had a friend support me in the way she did through that. And I can never thank Allie Davis enough. And I truly think my heart will hurt forever. But I know she's singing in the Angels Choir, and she's being the star of the show. And she will always be the star of the show in Prestonsburg, Kentucky. Thank you, Allie Davis.
Allie was one of the sweetest people that I think has ever graced this planet. So incredibly talented, and just so undeniably such a nice and good person. Even for the time that I got to spend with her all those years in the theater, I am so thankful. And all my love and prayers go out to you too, because I can't imagine how hard it is. And just know that I love you all, and I'm praying for you all, and even though this is a big loss, you are strong enough to get through this. So
I have a million memories with Allie, because I've known her my whole entire life. But I'm going to tell you this one that I don't know if you know. So you know we was together in the show Broadway Kids. Well, it was opening night, and I was a nervous wreck, because I was about ready to go on stage to do my speaking part. And I was a nervous wreck, and I was shaking, and I was ready just to say, I'm done. This was a mistake. I don't want to do this anymore. Allie wasn't having it, though. So she grabbed a hold of me, and she was like, let's dance it out. So we danced my nerves out until I felt better. And I went out on stage, and she was right there behind stage watching me. And from that night on, we always met behind the curtain, and we would dance out the nerves until we felt okay, and she always made sure that she was there to make sure that we danced it out. And I'm always gonna remember looking crazy but not giving a care in the world, because we had fun doing it. And I could go on and on and on about all the amazing things that Allie done in my life. And I could tell you a thousand different stories, but I'm not going to, not right now. But one thing I am going to say is I feel sorry for the people who didn't get to meet Allie, because she was such an amazing person, and everybody that knew her loved her. And I just want to say thank you for Allie.
Hi, my name is Trace Dean, and I got to work with Allie, gosh, over a decade ago while directing for Jenny Wiley Theater over a summer. And I only got to work with her a very short amount of time, but she made a huge impression, because I remember her smile, which seemed to light up any room she was in or any location she was in. Her personality was so charming. And she was so charming and so easy to work with and be around. And her talent was off the charts. And I just wanted to say that my heart and my prayers and my thoughts are with you, her family. She was definitely a light in the darkness. And Allie, may God bless you and keep you always.
I met Allie at Jenny Wiley Theater in 2011, doing Annie. It was my first professional show, but I believe that Allie was the true professional there. She always was on top of her stuff, even at a young age, at that young age. I remember when she went on for Annie and the excitement there was for that, and I'd never seen a cast come together and support this one person so much. There was so much encouragement, so much excitement for her. I just remember we all were in the wings, you know, watching her after we'd done the show, I don't know how many times, and just to see her nail it. She did, you know, she did great. I was always impressed with her over the years. You know, I get to see her grow up through social media, and just get better and better and better. And, you know, just to know that as talented and as beautiful as she was and as great of a smile she had, she was also kind. And that, I think, is the most impressive thing at all, of all. She will be missed. She impacted so many people's lives. And I'm praying for her family and friends.
Hey, Barry and Betty. I just wanted to offer my condolences and tell you that everyone is going to love and miss Allie. She was a beautiful example of what we want our daughters to grow up to be. She was smart and beautiful and funny and very talented. And I just want to say that my prayers are with you. And if there's anything that I can do to help or just to be there, just let me know.
I've known Allie since I was little, and I'm so thankful that I got to grow up next to this talented and so gorgeous girl on the inside and out. Allie was perfect in so many ways, and it didn't matter if she was walking on stage or walking into a room, she could make everyone there smile without even saying anything. And since the day I've met Allie, I've looked up to her more than anyone, and it didn't matter if she was doing someone's makeup, or telling a joke, or performing. I was just astonished by her. And I remember my whole childhood thinking, I want to grow up and be just like Allie Davis. And I wanted to inspire people the way that she did. And I'm so blessed that I've got to learn from her beautiful soul. And heaven has gained such an amazing angel. So, when I say she's gonna be missed, that's an understatement. Thank you for your unconditional love and kindness. Fly high, girly. We love you.
There's a heaven up there.
It's Emma Claire, and I met Allie at Junior Wiley. We were doing Shrek the Musical together, and I just remember how beautiful of a person she was. She had this amazing voice, this amazing personality to go along with that, and I have always looked up to her since then.
I wanted to get on here and say some things about Allie. She really was someone that just lit up a room. She could always bring the mood up no matter how sad everyone was or if anyone was upset. She always knew the right things to say to people and had the funniest stories to just really bring everyone up. She always made everyone laugh, and she'd have the funnest games for everyone to play. She was always really great with like the younger kids in the theater, which was really awesome to see and just something that was like really inspiring to me. I was only a year younger than her, but she was someone that I still, like, I have always looked up to. Someone that I had strived to be like, someone that I was like, you know, she's worked so hard and she put so much into everything. I want to do that. I want to be like that. And just had such a good attitude about everything. Even when she was down, she never really let you see it when you saw her in person. She just was someone that was truly inspiring to me growing up and someone that I really loved to be around whenever we would do all the theater stuff. It was like she just had that personality just drew you to her, and like she was so much fun all the time. Definitely someone that I would love my daughter to be like. I just found out I'm having a girl, and she is 100% someone that I would just be so grateful if my daughter could even have like an ounce of that Allie energy. But you guys are in my prayers, and I feel so much for you guys. I'm sending all of my love and all of my prayers your way. Bye. When I find
myself in time.
So I had the honor of getting to meet the beautiful and talented and amazing Allie in the summer of 2010. And all those words I just used to describe her, they don't even scratch the surface of who Allie is. She had this infectious smile that when you saw her, the room lit up and you wanted to know her. You wanted to smile with her. You wanted to laugh with her. But beyond her outward beauty and her talent, she had this beautiful soul. I remember my little sister would come backstage a lot at our Kentucky Opry shows and want to hang out with the big girls, and Allie was always so kind and so warm to her. And I think that if we can take anything from knowing Allie, it is to spread the kindness that she shared with everyone like confetti, and to just shower people with love and just be an Allie in the world. Show love, show kindness, show compassion. Be the shining star that this world needs right now.
I think one of my favorite memories that I can think of and that I will forever cherish with her was our junior year of high school. Me and her and other girls, we planned that every night of Nutcracker we were going to have a sleepover. So, you know, we would go to the morning show, we would come back to somebody's house, go to the night show and stay all night. And we did that every day of Nutcracker, and the memories that we made those 3 days, can't even describe how much fun we had those days. You know, we weren't even doing anything. We were just all just with each other, and she just could make us laugh so hard. She was so funny and made us laugh, and we had the best times just sitting around with each other, not even doing anything. And I will forever cherish those days with her more than anything in this world.
I have known Allie since we were 3 years old. I had the honor and privilege of getting to grow up with her and have her as my very best friend in the world for many years of my life. And I'm just gonna be real. I have recorded and re-recorded this video maybe 50 times today, trying to find the right words and trying to find what I want to say. And I can't find it. Because what do you say when this light in your life is just suddenly gone? So I'm just going to say this. Allie was the embodiment of spreading love and spreading light into other people's lives. Anytime she walked in a room, it was like she brought joy with her. And that's the Allie I've always known. That's the Allie that I'm going to remember for the rest of my life. and for the rest of my life, and I'm certain the rest of everyone's lives that she touched, we are going to be an Allie, as Betty says, and spread love and light to everyone around us. Because I know as long as we continue her legacy and let her live in our memories, she's not gone. She's still here with all of us. I just want to say, Allie, I love you. I miss you like crazy. And I know you're here. And Barry and Betty, I love you guys so much. My heart is with you. I am praying for you continuously. And no, we are not gonna let her light go out. And I know, personally, I am not gonna let her light go out. So, know that she's going to live on in all of us. I love you guys so much. She's still here.
My name is Misty Daniels, and like Allie, I grew up performing at Jenny Wiley Theater and at the Mountain Arts Center. And when I was at Jenny Wiley, I had the great honor, I would say, of performing in a lot of the family-friendly shows. And a number of my fellow actors didn't love those kinds of productions. They didn't like performing for kids. They didn't like performing with kids. And I get it, you know, it's not for everybody. But I loved it because I had grown up being a kid actor, and every time I performed with another child performer, it took me back to that time and why I loved theater and why I loved performing. And I loved standing in the jointed line at the end of the night and seeing the kids with their eyes as big as saucers because they believed that you were Belle or Dorothy or Cinderella. And sometimes on those nights when you see the kids, it wasn't that they had enjoyed the production or, you know, gotten lost in the story. It was something beyond that. You know, sometimes you would see kids who, and they probably were even too young to articulate it, but it was almost a sense of recognition. Like when they saw that show, they saw their destiny. When they saw the actors, they saw their community. And I remember when Allie came to see Beauty and the Beast. I remember it vividly. And that was the look on her face. And it was such a joy to watch her God-given talent through the years. And not only the talent that she had been gifted with, but so much beyond that, she possessed the dedication and the grit and the energy and the passion for the work that she was doing. And I knew she was going to be fine. You know, sometimes I would have conversations with her grandmother, and who would understandably worry about the challenges of a career in the art. And I never worried about Allie. I never worried about her because she had everything she needed to be a success. And I thought it was an inevitability. I thought it was a foregone conclusion that I would one day buy a ticket to her Broadway debut. And when I got the call this week, I was stunned. This was not what I saw in her future. And I have loved the Davis family for many, many years. They are dear friends of my family, and I am so sorry for everything that you're experiencing, but please know that I love you. I offer you my deepest condolences, and I'm so grateful to have known that wonderful girl. And thank you for sharing her talents with all of us. Love you.
So a few years ago, I was trying to explain Allie to a few of my NKU theater friends. I wanted them to know how excited they should be to meet her and to work with her. And I learned how hard it is to pin her down in a sentence, or a novel, I would say. She is impossible to explain in words. And even when I tried, it was almost like they didn't believe me, like I was talking her up a little too much. But a few years later, one of my friends told me that no matter how hard I tried, once they met her, they just couldn't believe how awesome she was. And I think you'll hear that a lot in this video, just how unique Allie was. And though I didn't know her incredibly personally, we were never like best friends, I was very lucky to be a part of a lot of communities that she impacted. From the time that I was 6 to the time I was 23, I got to see just how much she invested in people and how just strong her presence was in every community. My favorite conversation that I had with her, she was late to a voice recital one day in high school. And I asked her, I was like, how are you? And she was explaining her day and why she was late. And I'm pretty sure she performed in like 3 different counties that day. It was insane. But her response was something to the sort of, my mom's an angel. I wish I remembered her full words to that conversation. So Betty, thank you for driving her everywhere and sharing her with so many people. Nothing I was a part of would have been the same without her. So thank you so much. My heart's with you, and I'm praying with you guys. We love you, and we love Allie.
When I first met Allie, it was the summer of 2009, and it was my first summer at Jenny Wiley. And I was nervous because I didn't know anyone, I didn't know what to expect. But then I was introduced to Allie, and she immediately took me in, and I had made my first official theater friend. Fast forward many years and many plays with Allie later, and she was always just that go-to girl, whether you needed a hand, some help, encouragement, whatever you needed, Allie was there. Especially on the long days and the days that we were just exhausted. I know there was many times throughout the years and throughout different plays when we just wanted to go home, and Allie never said a negative word because that's just who she was. She had the most uplifting, positive personality. She was always there to encourage us, to get us through the day, and I truly believe that that's what got us through the long, exhausting hours most of the time, was Allie. Allie had that personality that whenever you left the conversation, you were either laughing or smiling. It wasn't possible to leave a conversation with Allie Davis and not feel better than before you talked to her, because that's just who she was. Allie was always willing to do whatever she needed to make everyone happy. She loved making people happy, and that was just, you know, what made her so special, was because she just loved people and she loved life. And whenever people think of Allie Davis, I know that they're gonna think, you know, she was this amazingly talented girl who could do anything that she wanted to, which I have no doubt in my mind that she could. But whenever I think of Allie, I am always gonna think of the most selfless, caring person that I've ever met. And her talent was just a gift from God. It was just a bonus. But her personality was really what made Allie, Allie. So to Allie, thank you for the theater memories. Thank you for being the definition of a true friend. And thank you for just being you. I know without a doubt that my theater experience would not have been nearly as awesome had you not been in it.
Heaven truly gained an angel whenever they gained you. And to Allie's parents, I am so incredibly sorry for the pain that you are experiencing. I know that there's nothing I can say or do to take that away from you. But I hope you find comfort somehow in knowing how special of a girl she was and how much she meant to everyone that she met. She may be gone in body, but her spirit will live on forever. Thank you for raising such an amazing daughter who would one day become one of my best theater friends.
Hi, Mr. and Mrs. Davis. I just want you to know that I love Allie. I love every single thing about her. I can't even imagine all my time at Jenny Wiley Theater without her. She's like the epitome of the Jenny Wiley kids. I just can't think about her and not smile. She was so bubbly and so sweet, and she just made everybody feel so welcome and happy. Literally, you can't be around her and not be happy. She's just so infectious. And she had so much passion. She was so talented. Just incredible. Allie Davis is incredible. In every sense of the word. And I'm praying so much for you all and the rest of the family and for all the friends.
For over a decade, I've gotten to share the stage with my cousin Allie, and it's honestly been the privilege and an honor of a lifetime to see her talent and to see her just really touch others with that talent and how much impact it's had on other people that we didn't know about until this week. And it's really, really meaningful to see how many people have told their stories of her and how she had impacted their lives. And I got to thinking about all the times that we had shared the stage together and how many different stages we shared together and how many different audiences we got to see and express art to and express emotion to that we didn't even know. And when I got to thinking about that, I was just thinking about how blessed we are to have had those memories together. This week, one of my closest friends said to me, God chooses the most beautiful flowers for his bouquet. And I think that's really true. I think that's probably why he chose her. She's so beautiful. I'm so talented, he needed her. But I got to thinking about all the bouquets that we had given to each other, from families giving them to each other and us too sharing that with each other, and how many bouquets we had gotten. And it really led me to the point of just because that bouquet isn't in my life anymore, that I didn't get to keep it forever, doesn't mean I'll ever forget how beautiful it was. And I think that's how she'll always be in our lives. I'll never, ever, ever be able to forget how beautiful Allie was.
Sending you so much love during this incredibly difficult time. We're all so heartbroken because of the connections and relationships that we had with Allie and your family. I know when I worked with her, I think she was like 11 years old, but I couldn't speak highly enough about her professionalism, her attitude, her work ethic, and her lack of ego. It was just no ego, and I think that so much of that was a testament to you guys. You guys are incredible parents, And it was apparent then, and it's apparent now. Sending you so much love. Thank you for all the light that you've shared with us throughout.
I think that my favorite memory with Allie would definitely be the show, The Legend of Jenny Wiley, me and her playing sisters. I remember coming in to the backstage area. It was my first show I'd ever been in. And Allie jumped up on the counter in front of the mirrors in the dressing area and started talking 90 miles a minute. She was like, "You're gonna love the theater. It's so awesome. This place is great. You're gonna have such a good summer." And it honestly was one of the best summers I've ever had in my life. And anytime that I do this, that I think about Allie. Anytime I braid my hair, I think about her, because Allie taught me how to braid hair. We were sitting in May Lodge at Jenny Wiley Theater doing a rehearsal one day because I think it was raining. And the prop that I had for my character, she had a doll, and the doll's hair was made out of yarn. And Allie taught me how to braid hair with the yarn that was on the doll. So anytime that I braid my hair, I always think about Allie. And I'm definitely going to continue to think about Allie when I do that. I'm just blessed to have gotten to meet a girl as amazing as she was.
Hi, you may not remember me. My name is Sahar LaForce. We were in several shows together at Jenny Wiley, and though we were both so young, and she was a year or so younger than I was, I really looked up to Allie for both how outgoing she was and how good of an actress she was, and she was just a really genuinely good person. We may not have kept in contact, but throughout the years, I've kept tabs on her, and I was always immensely impressed by what she did as both an activist and an actress. The people around her whose lives she touched will always remember her as a sweet, ambitious, and hardworking person. The love that you guys gave her was a big part in that. She was one of the best at Jenny Wiley, and I miss her, and I'm so sorry for your loss. You are all such wonderful people, and I hope that you guys find some solace in this.
First childhood friends. I mean, I had friends at school, but I don't think that anybody, I could relate to anybody like I could relate to you, and that's through our love for performing. We just loved it, and we were always beside each other, and we always supported each other through it all. Our Jenny Wiley days were the best days of, honestly, my life, one of the best days of my life, in my childhood memories. And I spent this whole week just reminiscing on how lucky we were that we connected through theater and performing, and our passion and love for that. You're gonna be missed a lot. There's a lot in this world. There's literally no one like you. And when they say be an Allie, it's never more true. Your personality is so vibrant, and you're so selfless, and you're so caring of other people. And you're honestly one of the greatest people I ever had the pleasure of knowing. And I'm so lucky that we crossed paths. You're gonna be missed, and I love you. I also wanted to address Betty and Barry. I love you all too. Thank you so much for everything you've done for me over the years, of mine and Allie's friendship. You really did good raising her. You should be really proud. She was a great person. But I just wanted to say you all are my deepest prayers. And Allie's gonna be missed, but I know Allie's always positive, and she wouldn't want us to mourn her death. She would want us to celebrate her life, and that's what I'm going to continue to do, celebrate her beautiful 21 years of life.
I'm lost without a cause, after giving it my all.
So I think the number one thing that comes to mind when I think about working with Allie all those summers at Jenny Wiley would be her eagerness and willingness to learn and constantly not only just like get better, but just constantly do the thing, you know? Like, I think it's very common for a lot of us to, I don't know, you know, get worn out or worn down after a really long day, or just, you know what, I cannot do the scene again. I just can't do it. If I have to do this again, I'm gonna positively scream. And that just never happened with her. It was always just, instead of I have to do this, it was always I get to do this. And every single thing was an opportunity just to be there. And I think that is a beautiful and very rare thing, especially in our field. And I, to this day, as a woman 10 years her senior, look up to. And I think that, you know, not only just people in the theater industry in general, but also just everybody, I think, should incorporate more of that into their daily lives. Just this kind of like, I get to do this. I get to do this every day. And that's awesome. And I can't wait. And that excitement and that eagerness and that, just that pure something. I don't even think there's a word for it. Just alley-ness, you know? It's just so amazing to me. And never ceased to be amazing. And I think that's pretty dope. So, I think that it would be safe to say that if we're having a particularly tough go at it, to just, you know, what would Allie do? And she'd probably put a smile on, go hug somebody, and then just do it and feel good about it. And I think that's something that's worth noting. Yeah. Set me free.
Hi, Mr. and Mrs. Davis. I'm Reagan Linton. I met Allie at an audition workshop for Jenny Wiley when I was about 8 years old. I think Allie would have been about 6 or 7. And it was my first summer working with Jenny Wiley, and I was shy and nervous and didn't know anyone. And that day, Allie was the first one that made me feel included and like I belong there. And our first activity at the workshop was an improv, which I had never done. And I was so nervous until I watched Allie perform, and we had to use a prop. And Allie's prop was a makeup kit, which is so funny to me now since she grew up loving makeup. And I remember thinking, I've never met someone so confident or funny or just larger than life like Allie. And I admired her every day since then. And you know, not only was she talented and beautiful, but she also had a gift for making people feel special and included like she did me that day and every summer that I got to work with her. So thank you for raising such a wonderful person. It was a blessing to get to know her and watch her perform and just be Allie, be who she was. You all are in my thoughts and prayers every day. And take care.
You know, it's hard for me to do anything except smile when I think about Allie Davis, because for as long as we've worked together and as long as I've known her, that's all she made me do was smile. She had this incredible talent that she made seem so natural and effortless, but you knew was backed up by so much training and discipline, because she had a professionalism about her that you just couldn't teach. And not only that, she was so incredibly kind. And everyone that had the privilege of sharing a rehearsal room with her, sharing a show with her, or just sharing life with her as a friend, learned something from her. I was older than her, but she taught me so much, and I looked up to her in so many ways. And, you know, it really rings true that in a world where you can be anything, you should be an Allie, because we all had so much to learn from Allie while we had her with us, whether it was on stage performing or out in the world and caring about things that were larger than ourselves. She was such an incredible human. And not to get too cliche, but to quote, you know, it keeps coming back into my mind, she loved Wicked as much as I did. And it just makes me think of, because I knew you, I have been changed for good. And because of that, she will always be a part of me, and she will always be a part of all of us that had the immense privilege of knowing her and sharing this life with her.
There's really not much to say, except for Allie was one of the most amazing people that I've ever met in my entire life. She always lit up a room when she walked in, and especially the stage. I'm very lucky that I got to know her in my life, and it gives me great comfort to know that she was living life the way that she wanted to live. And that's more than some can say. Allie, we miss you. Rest in peace.
Hello, my Davis family. It's so hard for me to pick just one memory to share with you, so I'll say this. Regardless of seeing her on stage at the early age at Jenny Wiley, or if it was at the Mountain Arts Center, or if it was seeing her at the Mexican restaurant, Allie always had a smile, and she was always kind to everyone, compassionate and caring to those around her. She holds a special place in everyone's heart, as do you all. We've been through a lot of happy times there at theater together and anywhere, to be honest. I love you all. I'm praying for you all. Prayers for peace and comfort.
So Robert asked me to make a quick video, just, you know, telling a story about Allie. And I guess one of the big stories I remember about Allie is, I actually done Jenny Wiley. It was my first year in 2008. And, you know, I'd never acted before, so I didn't know anybody. And actually, I saw her one day. It was like the second day of rehearsals. I saw her at the Mexican restaurant in Prestonsburg. And she actually made a point to come talk to me. You know, we chatted and stuff like that. Just had a really good conversation. And it actually made me feel a lot more welcome. Into Jenny Wiley and stuff, because like I said, I didn't know anybody. And then also, the next day at rehearsal, I'd never done theater before, or danced, or anything, and I was having a lot of trouble with the dance steps for Broadway Kids for this song. It was called We Have Magic to Do. And I just was really struggling, and she actually helped me learn the dance steps, which was really cool of her. And that's what I think I'm gonna remember the most about Allie. Obviously, she was an amazing singer and amazing actress, but more than anything, I think she just had a way of making people feel so welcome, especially the people who maybe aren't feeling so welcome. I think she just had that personality, that outgoing personality to make people feel like they belong. I'm definitely praying for you guys. I'm so sorry for your loss. She definitely will be missed in Jenny Wiley and just all throughout Eastern Kentucky in general.
I am to share just a little bit of memory with you here today. I've had a really hard time recording this video because part of me doesn't want to accept that this is a real thing. But here we go. I got very honored and blessed to get to know Allie over the course of the last 12 years during Jenny Wiley and other area performances. And I remember watching such a gifted child work her way into becoming such a gifted adult. Allie had such a maturity about her that was unlike anything I remember seeing in anyone else. Allie was already in a professional mindset long before she even realized she wanted to do this for a profession. I remember in 2011 when I made my directorial debut, And with Pilgrim the Musical, and Allie decided that she was going to take a risk and be a part of that. I mean, that's what it was, a risk. A young 20-year-old guy directing a full-length musical. What I wouldn't go, we have to go back and change some of those things, but here we are. But I look back and I think about how it was Allie that should have been directing. Allie knew how to make things make sense for people who weren't getting it. I never had to tell her what to do, she just knew. The instincts were always there. And she always was able to give voices to those who were voiceless. And you fast forward so many years down the road, and here she is again, giving voice to the voiceless in her activism. I can't say whether or not my son will be blessed with a child. But if I am, I hope that I can instill those same things in my child that you, Betty and Barry, have instilled in Allie. We were all better people because we knew her. And we will all go forward with a piece of her with us. Although I wish I could have been able to say that she got to see that Broadway debut we all knew was coming. I'm thankful that she knew right from wrong, and that she wasn't afraid to speak up for it. During these next few weeks, months, I hope that all of these memories that are being showcased in this video can bring some sense of peace to your lives, and know that we're all thankful that you chose to allow us to be part of your family's life, but especially your daughter's. I'll never be able to say thank you enough.
Allie was such a bright light in this world. I remember my first summer at Jenny Wiley Theater, and I met Allie. She was so little, but she had the professionalism of someone who had been in the craft for years. But more than that, she was kind. She was a kind, sweet girl who actually cared for other people. And that's really a gift. And, you know, she made everybody feel welcome and part of the group. And she would be the biggest cheerleader and supporter. She always was that for me. So loving. And you know, the last time I was with Allie, we were running to get snacks for the cast of Shrek during tech, and she was telling me all about her dreams and how we would be in New York together and performing on Broadway together. And I didn't doubt it for a minute. I knew that she had it, and not everybody has it. But she had the talent and the drive and the heart. And I think the heart is what was the most important piece of that puzzle. I knew her ability to be kind, to be loving, to be welcoming, to be supporting to others would really propel her forward, because it was a business that lacked a lot of that. And she was wonderful. And she will be greatly missed. I truly believe a light in this world has gone out. And I'm praying for Betty and Barry. I hope that God wraps his arms around you tight. And I do believe, grieving with hope, that one day you will see her again. I love you. I loved her. And sending my thoughts and prayers.
Hey, Betty and Barry, I'm sending you all my deepest condolences during this unimaginably difficult time. I just want to start out by saying that Allie was truly a light on and off the stage. I've seen so many posts this week, and there's no doubt about it that Allie touched so many people's lives. And I'm just so grateful that I had a friend like Allie. I guess my first memory with Allie would have been when we were both in Annie together at Jenny Wiley. And I remember the first time I ever saw Allie perform. I was in awe at her talent, her personality, and I don't think that I ever saw Allie without a smile on her face. She was definitely one of a kind, there's no doubt about it. And my most fond memory with Allie was when we got a little older, both in high school, taking lessons off of Jennifer, and we signed up for what we called band camp for a week at EKU, and we roomed together. And I truly believe that Allie and I's friendship just grew to a whole nother level that week. I saw how goofy she was, and we just had the best time together that week. But I feel like Allie was just a person who made everyone feel so loved and welcomed, and there was no one else like her. She will be missed so much, and I just want you all to know that I'm sending you my love and prayers during this time.
Hey guys, good morning. You know, they asked me a few days ago to do this video, and honestly, I've been putting it off, not knowing what was the right thing to say. And Saturday at Allie's memorial service, when I broke down and you guys were comforting, giving me comforting words of thanks for the time I spent with Allie, then, and Betty said, there's nothing you really can say. And that's, it's so true. I mean, there's nothing I can say to make it better or make it different, but I can tell you what she meant to me and what a blessing she was to me. And Sunday, just yesterday, I was at the MAC for tech rehearsal for recital, and I was watching my babies, the smallest ones, practice, and all I could think about, I had sat in that same theater the day before for Allie's memorial, and how many times I'd watched her on that stage, grow up on that stage, in dance, in singing, in theater, and I'd seen her in so many things on that stage. And for me personally, I mean, I remember her and that tiny, when she was in pre-ballet, and the little periwinkle with the white fur and the white snowflake, and I remember her as a clown, and all those nutcracker parts in between. I remember when she first got on a lead, how she was just so tiny, and her last recital when she danced the Dewdrop so gracefully, and that smile just lit up the room. And I'm just so thankful for all those moments that I got with her. I said I wasn't gonna cry. But I'm really thankful for that time I got to spend with her. And I think about just all, even after she, you know, didn't do a lead anymore, and all the time I got to spend with her on Adams and the Dance Cats and choreographing. And I know anytime we needed somebody to do something crazy or out there, we're always like, oh, Allie will do that. You know, whether it be a crazy dramatic speaking part or a crazy lift, them lifting her around, flipping her around, and whatever it was, she would do it with a smile on her face. I remember when we were doing the Diamonds dance and we were going to put somebody up on the box with the ring, and we're like, oh, that definitely has to be Allie. And she just had such a light that just shined. And again, I'm just so thankful. And seeing all the people that she touched, I've just never seen anybody like that that touched so many ages. All the little ones that looked up to her and admired her, and then all of her peers, you know, that just loved her so much. Gregory, you know, my Gregory, he's so backward, and he always loved her so much. She was always so good to him. And when this happened, it just broke his heart. He said, Mom, she was just always so nice to me. And I said, Gregory, she was nice to everyone. And she really was. And he always did say, Mom, Allie Davis is hands down the prettiest girl in the whole school. He just thought she was beautiful. I'm sure he never told her that because he's super backward, but he really appreciated how good and kind she always was to him. And she made him feel comfortable. She made everybody feel comfortable, whether it was like with a goofy joke or her laugh or whatever. She just made other people feel happy and feel comfortable. And some of my memories, I know I always say the singing the Coal Miner's Daughter, but it's so funny because she could sing anything, but we always made her sing Coal Miner's Daughter. I don't know why. I guess because when she was really little, she always sang that. And so when she was little, even when choreographers would come from other places, the girls would be like, oh, you gotta listen to Allie sing Coal Miner's Daughter. So we would all circle around and she would sing it for him.
And they would always be amazed at that voice that came out of that tiny body. But it was just funny that we always made her sing that song. So wherever those people came from, they probably thought we were more country than we really were, even. Because she was doing Coal Miner's Daughter. And then I think of her in, I guess probably middle school age, whenever she was doing that, the Halloween show at the Opry, I think, and she was doing Bloody Mary. We were having an elite sleepover, and I guess she must have had a show. I don't know if she had a show or she just that night, or she and then came to the sleepover, just did it to be funny. But she came to the sleepover and banged on the doors, all dressed as Bloody Mary, and of course it terrified the girls, and she just thought it was great. She thought it was hysterical, and that was funny. The girls loved that after the fact, after they weren't scared anymore. But I don't know. It's been, you know, I just. Again, there's no words you can say. I hate this. It's nobody deserves this. I've been praying so hard for you guys, and I'm going to continue to pray for you. But I just want to say thank you. Thank you for blessing me with all those years, 15 years of getting, you know, to work with her in so many different aspects, from regular classes to elite to the dance teams at Adams in the high school. Just every moment I got to spend with her was a blessing to me, and I thank you guys for that. And I love you guys, and I'm gonna keep praying for you and have you in my thoughts.
You know, when I think about Allie, I think about, you know, probably like a lot of people, the first impression is there's this like big smile, there's this like great sense of humor, there's this infectious energy, and just this monster talent in a really little kid. We worked together over a few years and we did a bunch of really fun shows together. And now the thing that I think about the most, I just think about all like the thousands of people that she entertained over the years at the Mountain Arts Center, at Jenny Wiley Theater, at school, in the dance recitals, with her dance troupe, at NKU. The fact that she brought smiles to so many faces, and in the case of Ghost Stories, that she brought screams of terror from packed houses of school kids, which might be my favorite memory of the two of us together. That's the stuff that I'm going to think of now, and I think that, you know, we were so lucky to have her as part of our lives, and I know that we're all going to have those memories for the rest of our lives, and that her impact is going to continue on. So I'm sending love to all of you, her friends and her family, and I'm thinking about you all.
Hi friends, it's a joy to be part of this community of friends of Allie Davis and to pay tribute to her life in this way. I just want to share a couple of ways that I have been able to be connected with Allie and her family throughout the years. The first time I met Allie, she was part of the cast of Pilgrim the Musical that I helped direct at the Mountain Arts Center back in 2010-2011, and then she and I got to be together on the stage at Jenny Wiley Theater through the production of The Secret Life of Girls. So it's been a joy to know Allie on the stage and off the stage, and just to see her in our community and the light that she brings. And I want to share just a brief memory from one of the times that's standing out in my mind of experiences that I had with Allie, and that was at a Big Sandy Idol competition. I don't remember what year it was, but I was there to support her and several other students that were there in the competition. And I remember watching the entire competition, and by the end of it, you know, I'm picking the winner in my head, and to me, Allie was the obvious winner. I don't know what year that was, and so if that was the year that, if you're watching this, if that was the year that you won, I apologize, but in my opinion, it should have been Allie. And I just couldn't believe it when they announced the winner. And so I went out into the lobby, and we were all congregating there in the lobby after the show, and I saw Betty and Barry, her mom and dad, and I remember saying to them, "This is ridiculous. She was robbed." Was there cheating? What happened? I don't know. But she should have won. She should have won this competition. And, you know, several others around agreed, and we kind of laughed and joked about that. And Allie finally came out, and I told her the same thing. "You were robbed." And Allie just said, "That's okay. You know, it was good." And she went on to brag about whoever it was that won and that they were good too. And I just, so much grace and joy in her spirit. And I thank God for that. I thank God for that memory. And I was just thinking about if I were to see Betty and Barry now, I think I would have those same words. You were robbed. You were cheated. And that's the way it feels. And that's a right way to feel. Because that's the truth. We were cheated. They have been cheated. They have been robbed of their daughter's life. Because death is an enemy. It has cheated and robbed us of Allie's life. But we gather here today to cling to the good news that Jesus Christ has defeated the enemy of death, and he holds the keys of hell and death, and that because Jesus Christ lives, Allie also lives. The prophet Isaiah told us that we long for the day when death will be no more. He will swallow up death forever. The sovereign Lord will wipe away the tears from all faces. And so I just want to join you in this time of closing in prayer for Allie and for her family and for these overwhelming deep feelings of grief and loss that each of you here are experiencing, and to pray for you and to pray with you that the sovereign Lord will comfort you, that you will continue to hold on to the hope that is in Christ Jesus, which has called us heavenward, and that you will be able to give thanks and rejoice in Allie's life. So would you pray these prayers with me? Jesus, our friend, you wept at the grave of Lazarus. You know all our sorrows. Behold our tears and bind up the wounds of our hearts. Through the mystery of pain, bring us into closer communion with you and with one another. Raise us from death into life, and grant in your mercy that with Allie, who has passed within the veil, we may come to live with you and with all whom we love in our Father's home. God of us all, we thank you for Christ's grace, through which we pray to you in this dark time. A life we love has been torn from us. Expectations the years once held have vanished. The mystery of death has stricken us. Oh God, you know the lives we live and the deaths we die, woven so strangely of purpose and of chance, of reason and of the irrational, of strength and of frailty, of happiness and of pain. Into your hands, O holy God, we commend Allie's soul. No mortal life you have made is without eternal meaning. No earthly fate is beyond your redeeming. Through your grace that can do far more than we can think or imagine, fulfill in Allie your purpose that reaches beyond time and death. Lead Allie from strength to strength and fit her for love and service in your kingdom. Into your hands, O God, we also commit our lives. You alone, O God, make us to dwell in safety. Whom finally have we on earth or in heaven but you? Help us to know the measure of our days and how frail we are. Hold us in your keeping. Forgive us our sins. Save our minds from despair and our hearts from fear. And guard and guide us with your peace. In the name of our holy Christ, we pray. Amen.